is well divided into half and half pictures. Your private sector banks are looking good. The larger mid-cap, PSU, broader market banks are coming under pressure in early trade. Stock of the morning has got to be RIL. After that big move on Friday, the gains continue. 300% has been added to Reliance Industries. Or long built up, very obvious. 1220 is what we have on the counter. The stock undergoing a current breakout. Infosys is up 2.5%. Sun Farm is 398. It's off the day's high point, but trading the 398 to 404 range. The 2% rally playing out on Sun Pharma after a big fall that the counter witnessed last week. The day belongs to IT, so be it frontline or broader market mid-cap IT names, gains are across the board. Long build-up was obvious on Friday, and more importantly, the rupee is weakened substantially, which is supporting IT and pharma counters in today's day of trade. Well, a couple of broader market gainers as well, if you want to take a look at those. You've got lots of smaller names as well that are in focus. So barring the Sun Pharmas of the world, you've got big moves on counters like Lind India, which is up 6.5% odd. Sun Pharma, Spark is another big gainer. So Advanced Research is a counter that's actually your top mover in early trade. Take Solutions is doing well. Merck, Motherson Sumi, Dish TV, United Breweries are the kind of mid-cap movers in trade this morning. Joining us now is Nirav of Nirmal Bang with his top trades. Nirav, 11,000 in sight, and I'm assuming if 11,000 does get taken out, the up move may continue another 100 to 100 points. At 10,980, long trades in the Nifty advisable?
See, there are signs on the index. If you look, you know, as you said, the Reliance, you know, Infosys, or you look at HDFC Bank, the Kotak Bank, the Lupin, the Sun Pharma, all of the, you know, large cap stocks are actually witnessing long creation and, you know, going on to making new highs. You know, Infosys is within touching distance, Reliance already at 52-week high. So I do believe, you know, Nifty is going to head upwards. You know, having said that, 11,000 is a big resistance on the upside. The highest call built up is at 11,000 call strike. Now, in the last few sessions, we have seen liquidation coming in at 11,000, which is a good sign. Also, the base has come up from 10,500 to 10,700. Now, that put strike has the highest open interest amongst puts. So, you know, all in all, the signs are there that we will witness a breakout above 11,000. However, you know, buying is advised only above 11,020 levels. If you get a close above 11,000 for a day, then that will be great. You know, you can then buy aggressively for a target of about 11,200. I believe you can keep a stop loss of 10,880, you know, which is a good support area now on the downside.
Right. Couple of other verticals to talk about: Bank Nifty, the IT pack, and pharma. IT pharma, of course, gaining on back of a weaker rupee. And the general view on the street is that the rupee has stopped out and further weakness cannot be ruled out. How would you play Bank Nifty, IT, and pharma? Would you go long on any of these sub sort of indexes?
Yeah. So I'll go in order. See, for sure, pharma is the first index I'll be going long on. You know, all the stocks, in fact, you know, just bearing Sun Pharma and Woke Pharma, all other stocks are witnessing long creation and they're continuing to make a higher top, higher bottom formation in a longer term chart. So, and you know, rollovers have been very, very good for pharma in the last 2-3, you know, months. Now, for sure, I'll be going long on pharma. I believe, you know, for 6 months, they might just gain 20-25% from here on. So the first thing you've got to go long on is pharma. Secondly, if you look at Bank Nifty, you know, Bank Nifty is now within touching distance of its new highs. So it only is about, you know, 700 points away. I believe, you know, a lot of private and PSU stocks are primed to move up from here. So second index is the Bank Nifty index that I'll be going long on. I'll be definitely going long on Axis Bank, ICICI Bank, and HDFC Bank, if you ask me, because, you know, the patterns there are very, very good. You know, good long built up witness there. A lot of open interest has been built in, incremental open interest has been built in those counters. Even Kotak, for that matter, looks like it is primed to move up. You know, the other PSU banks like Canara Bank, State Bank, you know, all of them have witnessed very good rollovers in the last month and continue to do well in this month. So I believe, you know, those stocks can also be bought. So, you know, the second sector will be Bank Nifty. The third one, you know, coming to IT, I was not very sure of IT in this month, But the way Infosys has moved up, you know, and the other mid-cap IT counters like NIT Tech, KPIT or Tata Elxsi, all of those are now showing signs, you know, that they will move up another 5-10% from here on. So I'll be buying mid-cap IT right now, and you know, in the space of IT large caps, only Infosys is one stock that I'll be buying at this level, because I believe it can go up toward the 750-780 odd levels. The other stocks like TCS, TechM still need, you know, a little bit of long creation to come in, need some buying to come in at lower levels. I'm not very sure if that will come. So I'll be waiting and watching in that space.
What about mid-cap IT, Nirav? I mean, KPIT, Mindtree, beyond that as well, a stock like a Tata Elxsi. I mean, this one has been underperforming since its earnings, and I'd imagine it's only a matter of time that the counter starts rolling in some gains. Any contra calls on a Tata Elxsi? And if not that, what in the mid-cap IT pack are you going long on?
See, I'll be definitely going long on NIT Tech and Mindtree. Then, you know, looking at Tata Elxsi, Tata Elxsi is near its support zone. You know, it is in a consolidation, and the lower level seems to be around 950. You know, every time it comes here, it witnesses good amount of support at these levels. You know, I have seen a lot of shorts being built in the last few weeks, but now, you know, covering is there, and there are signs, you know, some longs are also coming in into this counter. So I believe it can go up towards the 1100 odd levels, which is a resistance, which is around 1070. So one can buy at current levels. I definitely feel one can keep a stop loss of 950 and take a bet towards 1070. The downside looks very limited at current levels for Tata Elxsi.
Right, NIT Tech, KPIT, Tata Elxsi, those are a few names worth mentioning. You said you'd go long on the pharma index. Any specific pharma names? I want to talk about DV's Lab and Aurobindo Pharma in particular. The likes of Biocon, Wockhardt are looking good. And also Sun Pharma, would you play for a sort of a pullback? Because after a 17% fall, I would imagine the counter should see some recovery, if not today, over the course of the next few days, right?
Yes. See, I'm one person who looks at volume very, very closely. So if you look, you know, its previous fall, you know, from 480 to around 400, 420 odd levels, there were considerable amount of volumes which had come in into the counter. Now, add to that, the RSI and the other indicators are in the oversold zone. Now, they are coming up, you know. Now, with this fall from 470 odd levels to about, you know, 380 odd, you've seen again volumes come in into this stock. And again, I believe, you know, this stock can move up towards the 470, 480 levels, you know. However, you have seen a lot of shorts in the last week, and those need to cover. I am seeing covering today, but you know, today's close will actually tell us if, you know, the covering is real, and if this covering does come in, you can see, you know, Sun Pharma again in this week come up towards the 450 levels at least. So one should be buying aggressively, yes, at current levels, but you know, closing is very, very important for today. So let it close above 405 for today, and then go long in this counter from tomorrow onwards. You can expect 450, 470 levels to come in. You know, there is good support or base building, which we say around this 380, 370 odd level. So, you know, that will be a medium term stop loss for Sun Pharma. One can go long.
Right. Stay with us, Nirav. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back and we'll continue our conversation. Stay tuned.
Maximize your earnings and savings with 6% interest on Yes Bank savings account. Yes Bank. India Bole Yes.
As trading comes to close, it's time to analyze the day gone by, the ups and downs, the winners and losers. It's time to count your gains, cut your losses with market experts, newsmakers, and game changers. Closing bets. weekdays at 2:30 p.m. only on Business Television India.
An insurance policy that covers you against injury due to an accident, a single policy covering death, loss of limbs and eyes, permanent and partial disablement, temporary disablement and medical expenses as optional cover. Presenting National Insurance's Personal Accident Insurance Policy. National Insurance, trusted since 1906.
Back, you're watching FNO Spotlight. Nirav, we've talked about a few stocks already, but anything that you're recommending where you're picking up sort of a long trade or a short trade today?
See, two stocks, both are longs. You know, BPCL, after a long consolidation, seems to have broken out above the 350 levels. I believe it can go up towards the 380 or 390 odd levels. You know, there has been good long built up in this counter. I believe it can actually, you know, not break the 340 levels. Now that becomes a very good support area. So I believe one can you know, take an option call here, buy the 380 call option with a stop loss of about 360 call option with a stop loss of about 2 rupees. It is trading anywhere in between 3.5 and 4. So one can, you know, buy this with a stop loss of 2 and, you know, go long for a target of about 8. The second one is a buy call on Mahindra and Mahindra. You know, if you look at this counter, there has been tremendous amount of consolidation which is going on. You know, there's not much open interest which is being built in the long or the short side, but you know, it continues to move in between 820 on the upside and about 730 on the downside. So it is near its support zone at this moment. Good volumes have gone in this counter in the previous few weeks. So I believe this stock can be bought. It is near its support zone. It is very unlikely that it will break the 720 levels on the downside. So one can buy with a stop loss of 722. It can go up towards the 750, 780 levels, you know, in the medium term.
Right, that's the call coming in on M&M. The stock, of course, looking the way it does. HDFC Limited reports numbers, and so does Kotak, Nirav. Anything on banking names that you're trading?
Yeah. See, for banking right now, my choice will be HDFC Bank. If you see, it has broken out above the 2130 odd levels, which was a strong resistance and a consolidation resistance at that. So, you know, breaking that took a lot of volumes. I believe it can come up towards the 2250, 2300 odd levels. So one can buy at current levels. I believe, you know, it has very good support now at 2120. You can keep that stop loss and go long in this counter. You know, the other one that I really like is ICICI Bank. If you look at ICICI Bank, you know, it continues to make a higher top, higher bottom formation. Even when Nifty was actually down, you know, from 11,500 to about 10,000 odd levels, this stock did not fall. And, you know, it shows the strength of the stock. I believe it can be bought at current levels, you know, with a stop loss of about 360. You know, it has got very good support around those areas. Some incremental open interest is being built in into this counter. And looks like long-term open interest, you know, long-term positions are being built in. So one can buy at current levels. I expect, you know, this stock to move up towards the 400, 430 odd levels, you know, in the coming time.
Right, that's the call coming in. Some of those banking names. ICICI Bank is one that a number of people have a positional long call on. Along with that, your mid-cap IT looks relatively weak. So stocks like IDBI Bank have moved one way from 64 to 57 now. Nirav, do you feel that a short trade is warranted on a name like an IDBI Bank?
See, I think last week also we've spoken about this. You know, I had given a short call here and I'll continue to give a short call in IDBI. I believe it can go down towards the 45, 48 odd levels. So one can short at current levels as well with a stop loss of 60. Doesn't look like, you know, it will go up again. You know, looks like, you know, at least 45, 48 should come in probably 2 to 3 weeks. So one can go short aggressively here.
It's an aggressive short call coming in IDBI. It could be headed to levels of 48. That's the word from Nirav. Nirav, along with those names, I think Bata is also showing some signs of early weakness. Is there a trend reversal in sight here, and hence after months of outperformance, maybe a short call could be on could be a trade on Bata?
No, I don't think so. See, for Bata, it is in an uptrend, long-term uptrend, and for that to actually reverse, it needs substantial, volumes or open interest on the top. So that is not coming. This just can be a near-term sell-off. It can again witness, good buying around the 1130, 1120 odd levels. So if someone wants to actually sell, 1130 or 1120 is the level to where book your profits. The short call, I don't think should be done here. In fact, one should be looking to buy on dips, because the trend is positive for this stock, and open interest wise also, if you look the broader picture, it continues to attract long positions. So again, buy around 1130, you can expect 1200 to come probably end of this month or start of the next one.
Right. Apollo Hospitals, quick word on that one too. And along with that, L&T, it's off the day's low point now. In fact, it's almost trading positive. 13% open interest addition. Both those are the counters?
Yeah. See, Apollo Hospitals, I had expected it to move up, but it has surprised me by moving up so fast. I believe it could reach 1450, 1500 odd levels. There's some aggressive buying going on in this counter, so one should cash in and buy at current levels. Tremendous pattern it has made. It has actually broken out above the 1300 levels, and since then some aggressive buying has been happening in this counter. So one can buy even at current levels. You can keep a stop loss of 1350, which now becomes a very good support area on the downside, and look for targets of 1420 and 1450 odd levels. Looking at L&T, it is in a consolidation zone, hitting the new highs around 1440, 1450 odd levels. It has come down. Now it is nearing its support zone, which is around 1260 odd levels. So I believe, that level will provide good support area for this stock. Having said that, if there is any trade in L&T, then I'll say no, not at this moment. Probably let it come down towards the 1260, 1270 levels. That is where you go long in this counter. Don't go short in this counter as of now, because the consolidation is such that whenever you feel like going short in this counter actually moves up, triggers the stop loss, and then again starts to move down. So there's no point in trading on the short side at this moment. Go long near the support zones.
Right. Thanks, Nirav. Good talking to you this morning. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Evner Spotlight. Thanks for watching. There's a lot more programming on the other side, so keep it with us.